It's pretty easy as you enter college to get caught up in how well you did on the ACT or SAT. Though these tests do have a correlation to college academic performance, they are not the be-all, end-all. There are other factors which include motivation, organization, emotional intelligence, and many other factors that affect whether or not you will be successful. So the purpose of this video is to address three areas you have control of which can increase how well you do academically. The first factor is class attendance.
I know, it's shocking.
Go to class. Well, duh, right? Not exactly. You may be surprised how many students skip class. Or you may not be surprised. But this is the one factor which has the most influence on academic performance and that you have the most control over. A meta-analysis of students' attendance and academic performance, which spanned over 80 years and included almost 70 papers, found that class attendance was a better predictor of academic success over any other known predictor. That is staggering to me. Attendance predicted performance better than high school GPA, ACT scores, and any other non-cognitive factors. Everything. Showing up to class is a powerful tool in your arsenal for success. But why is this? Well, for starters, going to lectures is another touch point with the material you are learning. Let's say you're reading your textbook to learn. Going to class is often a repetition of what you've read, a fleshing out of sorts. Sometimes you'll get a teacher that you may be tempted to be frustrated with who essentially teaches out of the book. This oftentimes frustrates students. However, you should view it as a gift. If the material in the book is being covered in the class, one, you can come into contact with the material more than once, but two, you get the opportunity to know what the instructor wants you to focus on. In a lecture, if the instructor is covering two or three topics from the book, then those are the things you should be devoting your time and attention to. Going to class also spreads out the learning. There are plenty of studies that have been done which indicate that it is better to spread out your learning than to cluster it into a shorter time frame. An example of this would be cramming for tests. Along this line of thought, you also have the opportunity to take notes, which you will have to study later. The other major factor that contributes to academic success is homework and studying. Yes, these are two different things. Since these are two different activities, let's define them. Studying is often thought of as reading over your textbook or going over your notes after class. However, I think if we are going to find a useful working definition, we need a more universal definition. Dan Hickey, the Academic Support Services Director at the Rochester Institute of Technology, defines studying as giving time and attention to gaining knowledge. Let me say that again. Studying is giving time and attention to gaining knowledge. That's a very broad definition, and I think that's why it is a strong definition. In another video, I talk about time management and how we must choose to place our attention somewhere. As humans, we are designed to focus our attention on something, so it is crucial to our existence that we focus on the right thing. This definition allows for studying to be in any realm of knowledge acquisition. This means as you play a video game, you are studying how to better complete the tasks set before you. As you learn to cook, you are studying how spices mix and ways of heating change the foods. If you take this definition and apply it to your classes, I believe it gives a greater clarity of purpose to learning course material. If you say, I'm going to go study for my US history class, this definition guides you in what that means. It means that you are going to go attempt to devote time to increasing your knowledge about the history of the United States. But not only that, when you study that history, you are attempting to make connections between the past and the present. You're trying to understand how those events have influenced today's life, and then, in turn, how we can live to influence the future for good. Makes that statement, I'm going to study for my US history class, have a lot more weight to it, doesn't it? So then where does that leave homework? Well, based on the definition of studying, I think homework seems to be a subset of studying. You are giving your time and attention to gaining knowledge, and homework tends to be practice of some kind of skill that you should have learned in class or from your textbook. This definition is not quite accurate, as maybe you could define textbook reading that will be quizzed over in a class as homework, purely for the fact that points will be awarded for reading and doing well on the quiz. Or you could define writing a paper to express your knowledge gained as homework as well. The major characteristics of homework is that it is mandatory, demonstrates understanding, and requires your attention. With this in mind, the best definition of homework, in my estimation, seems to be giving time and attention to a mandatory assignment to demonstrate knowledge gained. If this is the definition of homework, then I think we have a clear direction for how we should complete homework. When you do homework, it is not just about checking the boxes off and showing that you completed the task. It is demonstrating what you know. Homework is, in a sense, designed to teach you, but more so, it is designed to help the teacher understand what you know. As you complete homework, you should take every opportunity to show off what you know. The last thing I'd like to note about homework and studying is that there's pretty clear research which suggests that time studying does not necessarily translate to higher grades. There's no correlation between time studying and your grades. I think this demonstrates why the definition of studying is accurate. If you spend a bunch of time studying something that isn't relevant or you study ineffectively, it won't matter how long you spend on it, studying won't help. What's important is that you use your time effectively and you study the correct things. This This is why it is necessary to know your purpose. You've got to know what the teacher wants from you, and you need to also know what you want to get out of the class. It is integral to success in college. You've got to know your long-term purpose in life, because that purpose will define what you do with your time at every level, from each moment to each month. And I'm not talking about what you want to do with your life. I'm talking about who you want to be as a person. Look at your actions. They are an outpouring of who you are and who you want to be. Thanks for listening. Until next time.